All right. So yeah, big happy family hug.
Oh.
I have no idea how I'm gonna say this without crying. Okay, so I think I've said this before, but I'd always wanted to play D&D while I was growing up. I just never had any friends to do so with, so when you first asked me to partake in a campaign, that was already really awesome in and of itself. But beyond that, getting to be Faerthurn and welcome to the show's just been indescribable. I've legitimately learned things about myself, and I've come to terms with a lot of issues that I had. There it is. I can't say this without crying. This game really helped me sort through a lot of mental and emotional problems, and I can genuinely say that prior to playing this, I would not have been as comfortable as I am now letting myself be vulnerable in front of people. Your campaign really changed me for the better, Josh. There was a point towards the end where I said as Faye that this journey and these friends helped me become someone I could be proud of being, not just someone I can tolerate. I meant that. This campaign, these friends I've grown so close with, this world you created, all of it, it's just helped me so much more than I can describe. So Josh, thank you. Thank you so much for making this campaign and letting me be part of it. I'm really blessed to have you as a friend, and I'm so honored that I get to call you my dungeon master.
Your father is up front. If you actually take over the mantle of Illidamara, you will actually be his deity.
Many more that I'm sure that will come as quite the pleasant or even unpleasant surprise, I'm sure.
Yeah. I actually completely lost track of Owen and Rhyme.
They're right in front of Uthorian.
I was just checking to make sure he was okay. Do you want to go say hi, Father Lightbringer?
I'm sure I could say a few words to the family I left in Optimar all those years ago.
Do you want me to go with you?
You are welcome to tag along if you wish.
Come on.
Josh, I can't say how much it means to me that you indulged me and let me join in on Welcome to the Show. At first it was at someone else's insistence, but as I grew to love the characters that you and the others wrote, I really wanted to be more and more and more and more and more involved in it. Now I'm involved in about four campaigns because of you. And because of you and this campaign, I have some of the best friends I could ever ask for, and a huge support network, including just basically all of them. Thank you for indulging Rayan, really, and thank you for rolling with the punches with Hana when I accidentally screwed her up. Thank you for letting me be sexy Glazia, because that's funny as heck. Thank you for letting me roll with Fierna once we figured out the horrible dad angle. And even though we had our issues with Rhyme and stuff like that, thank you for letting me play. Be a playable character. And working with me to make her as epic and as helpful as she has been. I've needed these friends, and I've needed you pretty much since I've been in it since late 2017, like September, October, November-ish. And I feel so close with them, and I feel... basically, that's all because of you. So, thank you, my love. I needed Brony D&D so much. And I still will continue to need it, because I love it, and you've done an amazing job. Love you, sweetheart.
All right. So, as you approach the dwarven area, you hear Orcrim and Gardrim talking to each other.
I don't understand, my boy. If you hadn't died, why hadn't you returned?
I never returned because we were dwarves. We always talked about how we were supposed to be strong. We were supposed to be warriors. I was going to be the next king. How could I live up to that if my legs were like this?
You see Orcrim just like, he sticks his hand to his head and just hits himself really, really hard.
I have never hated my past self more than I do right now.
Voice from the wind. I can relate.
Verdok sees you approach, and he moves up to you. He's about to hug you, and he hesitates for a little bit before just like pulling you into a hug.
I really don't care right now.
It's good to see that there's been more father-son reconciliation as of late.
So, it's done. The question does need to be asked. What happens now between you and I?
I suppose you shouldn't doubt in yourself anymore. There were many other players in the works that, even though it caused great despair and misfortune in so many ways, it led to a greater level of joy and freedom that I still have yet to fully understand. I don't doubt either of us have regrets. But you needn't feel that you have to base your entire existence on such regrets.
I see. Willing to be
When Josh first approached me for making a character in Brony Dungeons & Dragons, I was hesitant. I had many experiences of people wanting me to join their D&D groups over the decades, especially in the case of my older brother, but I had a hard time thinking that this would really be for me. I suppose it really came down to, I just didn't have people to play with that I really, really wanted to spend so much time with. So, when Josh decided that this was going to happen, he was going to make sure that we were all gung-ho about this, no matter how many times he had to really convince us. And I decided, you know what? Okay. I will see whether we can get anywhere with this, but first, I want to be sure that everyone else in the group gets to be what they want. And then I could fill out the gap of whatever might be needed else. At the time, I hadn't really expected that I'd have that much fun with whatever part I was playing because I was just more concerned about balancing the group, I suppose. But Josh found a way. He found a way that I could be much, much more invested into my character than I could have expected. And between the two of us, we had decided early on, you know what? If we keep this curse a secret from the group and give very subtle hints here and there, it could lead to a grand surprise much further down the line. And because Josh was willing to go that much further for my sake, to make sure that everybody was having that kind of fun with the game, I felt invested. I felt, wow, this is something I'm looking forward to. Like, a lot. Especially in those early days, we were playing D&D sessions every week, maybe every other week. We were just go, 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 because this is so much fun. So I did want to thank Josh for really going above and beyond, making sure that everyone felt excited and passionate about what they were doing and who they were playing with. He really did go the extra mile to make sure that even I, when I was attempting to fill out whatever gaps in the group were needed to make it more balanced, he still found a way to make it all the more exciting for me. Thank you kindly, Josh. Thank you so very kindly for making sure that we were all gung-ho about this right from the get-go.
All right.
Yoot.
All right. So, let's move on to Ivan and Amber.
Well, there's a lot of people in the back I want to talk to, but I'm gonna start with who's right in front of me.
Yeah. So, Valkatov, Ivan, and Vizikra leap over the pews and hug the two of you.
Amber takes a deep, calm breath and then transforms into her form, human form.
Diane.
Perfect.
I need to get used to this. Used to not being scared anymore.
Ivan looks at all of you and says, I can't believe you guys did it! Well, I can. I always hope, but... You guys are my heroes. You know that?
Amber puts her hand on his head. I think I should be calling you my hero. Shouldn't I?
And his eyes widen, and you see him very, very calmly just give him the throat cut gesture. And then Valkatov and Vizikra look towards Ivan in confusion. What is she talking about?
Oh, nothing. He's just been praying for us from afar. He's been giving us strength in a non-direct way. We just wanted to thank him for that. He winks at Ivan.
Incontinent steeds are jealous of you right now, Ivan.
Wow. Okay.
Technically.
So Valkatov and Vizikra just shrug and say, "Yeah, that makes sense."
What was that, Josh?
Yeah.
Technically, steer like steer bulls.
Yeah, you're right. I realize that myself.
It's going to be great, you know, raising a family, not having to worry about anything anymore.
I'm not gonna lie, getting to see the two.
Then again, you could say it's horse crap.
In each other's arms, not only the first time, but the second time after what happens, I consider that one of the happiest things I've ever done on this journey.
Aww. Preach. Amber spots a Marta.
Yeah.
I say about this D&D session that I haven't already said in some of my other videos. This is the session that got me back into giving D&D a chance after a really rough and uncomfortable experience. Not only that, it provided me an opportunity to bond with my current friends and even made some new friends. I mean, I have never met Armel until Josh introduced her to me, and Lord behold, she became his wife at the end of the day. And then I also met Shay, and Shay's become a wonderful friend as well. I cannot begin to express how amazing this journey has been, because not only did I get to bond more with my current friends like Josh, Ellie, Doc, and Voice, and Ben, but also I was able to get out of my shell and able to enjoy what I used to do when I was a kid, and that was make-believe and pretending to be something I kind of hoped I would be. And if that weren't enough, it came to a point where I actually got a bit of catharsis in being able to express some emotional weight from losing a family member back in 2010 with my father. That was a very emotional but very deep subject for me, and if it weren't for this campaign, I don't think I ever would have been as confident as I am now in expressing my feelings more, and also improving on my artwork, for crying out loud. I used to hate drawing people. I detested it. I hated drawing people. I only drew ponies or creatures that walked with four legs. Not much has really changed, but I have been able to basically draw more people, and now I've gotten more comfortable, and I'm actually having fun drawing people now because of this D&D session. I cannot believe how addicted I got to this whole thing about D&D, and I have so much to thank to Josh for hosting it and hosting more games from then on, and even encouraging people like Eliora and Armel to host their own campaigns that I thoroughly enjoy very much. So yeah, Josh, thank you so much. You are a great friend, and I thank you for dragging me into this campaign kicking and screaming all the way, because it was totally worth it in the end.
All right, so I guess we can move on to
Challenge Bay Part 2.
Yeah.
Yes. You guys get to Part 2.
Oh, you see, yeah. Sylvester, they'll be there in memory.
I've played Dungeons & Dragons before, albeit the 4th edition. I stopped playing after 6 sessions because my group never had the chance to finish. We were also terrible at playing the game. When I was invited to create a character for a Dungeons & Dragons session in our Team Fortress 2 chat, I was itching to electronically roll the dice once again. Welcome to the show, at first I thought it was a neat little experiment to try out with friends. Just a chance to engage in combat and live out our high fantasy fanfics. By the final session, I never thought I would have a character who would take the leader position. Dungeons & Dragons has been the one thing I look forward to providing a dose of escapism. It's a healthy distraction from the work week and all the crap that goes on in the world. And when your job is literally covering 2020 from start to finish, sometimes you need to be with friends and roll natural 20s on Asmodeus' manifestation of his own soul. This group, through its ups and downs, got me through the worst of times. To that I say, thank you, Josh, for allowing my creative juices to flow, and thank you for helping me through the dumpster fire of a year that was 2020.
Alright, so, anyone else?
Yes. Well, before we do that, I was going to say, I've been sneak sub behind Gustro, trying to be as silent as possible. Got good news to tell Amber when she comes over here.
An ode to my first and favorite DM. Josh, over the course of a few years, you took us on a trip of biblical proportions, the equivalent of a Norse epic on a tabletop. And not only did I get a chance to spend time with some of my closest friends, but I got to witness their amazing improv and acting skills. A lot of us were complete beginners when we first started the campaign, but the further we went, the more we just fell in love with the characters and the world, and we just wanted to be a big part of it. I wanted Ivan to have an arc. I wanted to see him develop. I wanted him to have purpose in every episode. I wanted him to have an interesting backstory. I just wanted him to feel real. And you did that, dude. You made a game worth playing and a fantasy world worth living in. And you worked hard. Like, holy cow, did you work hard. I remember all the times you had difficulty or the programs were giving you issues. But you pushed through because you wanted this story to be told. And in the end, it was. You did it. We did it. And all the little things I remember, too. I started a demon dance party. I got a child named after me. I sang a song for my dragon girlfriend. I got inebriated by water. It was just so much fun. Welcome to the Show started as just a way to have fun with my friends, and it still is, it very much is. But you turned it into an experience, man. Like, you put me onto D&D forever, and I'm always gonna remember this as both my start and my bar for D&D from now on. Thanks for inviting me to play, man. Thanks for making me feel important throughout the entire campaign. Thanks for giving me an opportunity to test my acting abilities, and thanks for just being a charismatic, fun, dedicated, and hilarious leader. I honestly can't wait to go on our next adventure. So just... thanks, man. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, Amber is actually Adziadril and
Suzanne.
Where do I even begin with this? Should I start with how proud I am of Josh? I knew this was his first real-time DMing, so I honestly wasn't expecting much. Not that I thought it'd be bad, just competent. Passable. I certainly did not expect Brony D&D to be my show of the year for 2018 and the best campaign I've ever played in. I really cannot overstate just how thoroughly I enjoyed watching the series, following how Josh built his stories, the emotional ride he took us through, and the weight he delivered them with. I still get chills from the season 1 finale, but I also have gratitude. Gratitude for being allowed to be a part of this. Contribute my own ideas to its stories, to take a concept I had had in the back of my head for over 4 years, and finally get a chance to bring it to life for everyone to enjoy, to actually finally be able to create Ravus, to create that character, to see it actually play out, to play out an idea that I had been wanting to do for so long, just to see if I could, just to see if it could happen. Thank you. Thank you for the fun, thank you for the thrills, thank you for the horror, thank you for letting me write with you. Thank you for everything. I'm proud of you, mate. Dad, I can't stop there, can I? Bliss, I am so happy Josh was leaning in and let you be the dragon you wanted to be, because this series, no, this group could not be the same without you. You are to role players what Josh is to Dungeon Masters. You are a fantastically gifted, talented, and passionate person, unafraid to take risks and throw yourself into the game. Time and time again, you deliver some of the best scenes of any of us roleplayers, and we would have lost something special if you had never joined. Finn, I know everyone says keep being you, man, never change, and that's true. You bring so much happiness to the group. You are such a good friend, such a good person. But you did change. Above and beyond. If Ivan had just stayed as the ray of sunshine that he was, we would have loved that. He was already one of the best characters, but you decided, oh, I want to do more. I want to push myself. I want to test myself. I want to develop the character further, and you did a fantastic job of that, and just, well done. Boys, I loved watching how Jalen grew in Season 3. Seeing him step out of his shell like that and really step up as a leader was what made him grow into being my favorite of Directian's heroes. And you came up with so many creative ideas. There's a reason that, not just in character but out of character, Ravus considered Jalen to be his biggest threat because of your creativity. You wanted to play the rogue character, the smart character who uses his wits. You succeeded. Doc, speaking of creativity, you are a genius sometimes, sir. I love how you like to plan and think outside the box. You contributed so much to the identity of Welcome to the Show, and on a personal note, it was so much fun making the reveal of Fulgrim montage with you. Sweetie, thank you for your passion, both as a player and what you put out in your character. I don't know if you'll ever play with us again, but... You should do some kind of voice acting. You really have a talent. Ellie, I kind of think I owe you an apology here. See, I know I probably should talk about how much you've given to this series, or how fun your whip is, or how much I enjoyed Faye, but I find all of that keeps being overshadowed by what you mean to me. You extend the hand of friendship before anyone else. You made me feel welcome from the beginning, and you've helped me through so much. You've made me a better person, and I could not be more grateful I met you. Thank you so much for being my friend. Ari, we love you. We have always loved you. We love your work, we love how adorable Rain is. We love Rhyme's story, Glazier's delivery. We love your range, we love Hana's everything. We love how every one of your characters is an instant MVP. You're one of us. We admire you so much, and we are so glad you're part of this team. Thank you, everyone.
Where is Jem?
So, here we go.
Jay.
Sorry about the robot voice. I don't know how that happened. It was fine when I edited, fine when I recorded, and then just when I published it, it just came out like that.
Oh, Shay. Thank you, you evil bastard.
You're welcome. What are the comments? Help me, Max! I'm feeling!
It's really...
Oh, I love this bit.
The whole room has gone dead silent.
Dance, chat, dance. Throne room. I have been planning that for months.
You sneaky little son of a gun.
It's me. Did you expect anything else? Well, clearly, because you didn't see that coming.